We've all heard the story. A man is standing on the deck of the Empire State Building in New York City. He then takes out a penny and throws it off the edge to make a wish. But the penny falls from such a height that it hits someone down below on the sidewalk and takes them out. This is a classic tale which has been told for many years, but is it true? Today we're gonna look at the science and really see what would happen. I'm Charlie and today we're going to look at what if you dropped a penny off the Empire State Building. But before we get hit by a falling penny, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? So we've already gone over the famous story, but did you know that people have really tested this out? The Empire State Building is 1,454 feet tall, and one penny weighs around 2.5 grams. This means if you were going to throw a penny off the Empire State Building, it would travel at a speed of 64.4 miles per hour. One guy made a gun which could fire a penny at 64.4 miles per hour. They launched this into various ballistic dummies and found it caused very little damage. But that's not the only factor which would affect a penny falling from the Empire State Building. For example, if you're in an elevator and the cable suddenly breaks, then you'd likely survive the fall. That's because the elevator is in a very tight space. This would create an air pocket which would slow down your fall. And a penny creates a similar effect when it's falling from a great height. Because of the shape and weight of a penny, it doesn't simply fall down flat. Instead, it spins and tumbles around, slowing down its velocity. This means it may fall at slightly less than 64.4 miles per hour. And remember, this is in perfect conditions. I'm not accounting for any wind, rain, snow, or hail here. So, if the coin's going at an average speed of 60 miles an hour, that really is not very fast. Bear in mind that a bullet fired from a gun goes at around 1,000 miles an hour. In ballistics, things are often measured in foot-pounds. The average bullet would hit someone at around 100 foot-pounds. But a coin falling from the Empire State Building would hit someone at 1 foot-pound. And luckily for that pedestrian, it would not cause any serious damage. In fact, it would simply sting whoever it hit, and would not cause a crater in their head. Also, if it hit the sidewalk or the road, it would not cause a crater or crack the pavement at all. However, if it hit the window of a car, it would likely shatter the window. But what if someone threw a whole roll of pennies off the Empire State Building? A roll of pennies is 50 pennies, so 50 cents. These pennies would probably weigh about 50 pounds. And these pennies could reach a much faster speed of 250 miles an hour. That's about a quarter the speed of the average bullet. But it's also probably slightly heavier than the average bullet too. Well, if this hit someone on the head, then it likely would take them out, at the very least make them unconscious. So a single penny won't cause much harm to anyone if you throw it from the Empire State Building. But throwing a roll of pennies would be enough to take someone out, so don't do that. Scientists also say that if you throw a pen off the Empire State Building, it could pierce someone's head. So be very careful next time you go up to the tallest building in New York. And be even more careful if you're walking down below it. You might want to wear a hard hat just in case anyone actually tries out this urban legend. But now let's ponder one more what if question. What if you fell into a black hole? So first off, what are black holes? A black hole is where an object is so dense that gravity warps around itself. This causes space and time to be twisted. And because gravity wraps around space itself, it twists in on itself, creating a black hole. This hole burrows through the very fabric of reality as we know it. And most black holes are actually large stars which have run out of fuel. These are usually very dense and create a mangled bit of space. These dense, dead stars buckle under their own weight and collapse inwards. Space-time caves in with it and this creates a black hole. This is a region where there are no stars and all you can see is pitch blackness. The boundary of the black hole is called the event horizon. And that is the exact part where light attempts to escape the black hole. It's pretty much the part which is furthest away so that the black hole can't suck in all of the light. But go any closer to the hole than the event horizon and there's no escape. The event horizon is boiling hot as it's piled with energy. Quantum effects cause lots of hot particles to build up and radiate the outside of the black hole. This kind of radiation is called Hawking radiation, named after Stephen Hawking. And if you go into the black hole, it becomes more and more curvy as you go into the center of it. Eventually, it will become indefinitely curved, and space and time become meaningless. Inside the black holes, the laws of physics, that being space and time, cease to exist. But now let's ponder one very scary question. What if you were sucked into a black hole? Well, to really understand this, we need to look at it from two different perspectives. One will be from your own perspective, getting sucked into the black hole. and the other will be from your friend's perspective, who's also in space with you. Your friend will watch as you're sucked into the black hole. As you get closer to the event horizon, your friend will see you stretch and distort. It will be like seeing you go through a ginormous magnifying glass. Or maybe one of those house of mirrors you see at circuses. Point is, you'll be very distorted and bent out of shape. Not only that, the closer you get to the black hole, the more you'll appear to move in slow motion. That's right, for your friend it will be like seeing you move in a slow motion movie. Obviously you're in space, so you can't call out to your friend, but you could use sign language to communicate with them. Or maybe using a flashlight you could communicate using Morse code. Well, your friend will receive those messages much slower than you're putting them out. For example, if they could hear you and you went help, they would actually be hearing help. That's because light and sound waves are stretching, making them go way slower. Then when you reach the event horizon, your friend will see you freeze. It will be like someone's just pressed a pause button on you. You will then remain there totally motionless, but you'll be stretched across the surface of the event horizon. That's right, at that point you'll have distorted to the shape of a circle. You'll be laid out flat on the event horizon until a heat begins to engulf you. Your friend will then see you obliterated by hot particles. And before you even get into the black hole, you will be reduced to ash. So, that's what your friend sees when you get sucked into a black hole, but what happens to you? Well, the answer is, nothing in particular. Instead, you'll just be sucked into this black hole. You won't be stretched, nor will you be burnt by particles. Instead, you'll be free-falling, as there'll be no gravity. You see, a black hole is an artifact of perspective. This means your friend outside can't see through the black hole. This means that while they see you distort and then burn into ashes, you just go into the black hole and don't notice any change. Then once you're in the black hole, you can pretty much live out the rest of your life until you pass away naturally. Seeing as you're in space, this will likely be due to lack of water or food. It may be a hard concept to wrap your head around, being sucked into a black hole, never to return. But you can pretty much think about it like how you progress through time. For example, as you watch this video, you're going through time. Now, of course, you can't turn back and go backwards in time. Time pulls us along against our will, and that's exactly what a black hole does. You can't turn around or escape the black hole, you're just stuck in there indefinitely. And you can't turn around and escape a black hole any more than you can turn around and escape time. So you may wonder, if you're in the black hole experiencing zero gravity, then why did your friend see you distort and then be burned into ashes? You may wonder, is your friend just hallucinating? Well no, that's not the case. From their point of view, you really were burnt to a crisp. Everything your friend sees will be very real, and if they wanted to, they could even go and collect your ashes and bring them back to Earth. But at the same time, you remain as you are, being sucked into the black hole. The reason why this happens is because the laws of nature require you to remain outside the black hole from your friend's perspective. Quantum physics says that your information can never be lost. So this means your friend's laws of physics are not broken. But at the same time, you're also totally normal inside this black hole. You see, the laws of physics require you to both be outside the black hole as a pile of ashes and also inside the black hole totally fine. According to the laws of physics, you cannot be cloned. However, you can be in two places, meaning there can be one copy of you. It seems confusing how to your friend you're dead in a pile of ashes, but to you you're alive and in a black hole. For many years, physicists were baffled by this, and they called it the black hole information paradox. But in 1992, they solved this. A physicist named Leonard Susskind realized there is no paradox at all. That's because your friend never sees your clone, they only see a copy of you. Your friend will only see the copy of you as ashes, and you'll only see the copy of yourself as a regular human in the black hole. But your two clones can never be compared, this means no laws of physics are actually broken. So by now you're probably wondering, which is reality, are you dead or are you alive? Well, that's what's so amazing about black holes and what they've revealed to us. Black holes have revealed that reality is subjective depending on who you ask. There's your friend's reality and your reality, both are different and both are valid. So, because black holes break the space-time continuum, there's a clone of you that's created, and this creates two different forms of reality. But, will there ever be a way for us to break the laws of physics and actually see inside black holes? Well, it was only a few weeks ago that we got the first image of a black hole's event horizon. I'm sure you remember it as it went viral online. Now, seeing as black holes were discovered in the 1970s, look how far we've already come. It's only taken us around 50 years to get an image of a black hole's event horizon. So perhaps in another 50 years, we'll be able to see inside black holes without actually going into them. Right now, physicists say we cannot take photos inside black holes. But they said even if we could, it would take so long for black holes to actually be seen by these cameras. Think about it, the inside of black holes are billions of light years away. This means that by the time we'd have taken an image of it, it would have long evaporated. It takes around 167 billion years for a black hole to evaporate. But it would take even longer than that to decode the entanglement and actually get an image inside a black hole. That's if we actually had the technology to do this, which we don't. So sadly, we may never be able to compare two different kinds of realities with each other. But even so, it's pretty amazing to think that there's more than one version of reality. And Stephen Hawking himself even said that we live in a multiverse. This means there is infinite different versions of our universe right now. And each one is a valid reality, so reality is pretty much infinite. But now your mind has been blown, we now know what black holes are, what would happen if you fell into one, what your friend would see, and also what version of reality is real. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner, have you ever thrown something off a high building? If you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. There'll be a link to that on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.